1 Samuel chapter 3 begins in a place called Shiloh in Israel, and it features Eli the priest and Samuel the young apprentice. And the story is that Eli has kind of grown old and God's not speaking to him because he's disobeyed. He's allowed his sons to do evil things. And listen to verse 1. It says, "Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord in the presence of Eli. And the word of the Lord was rare in those days. There was no frequent vision." The word of the Lord was rare in those days. No frequent vision. The reason was because Eli wasn't obeying, and neither were the other priests who served under him, and neither were his children. So Samuel, he's described as the boy here in chapter 3 because he was young. He was probably, some say, at this time around 12 years old. And that night, while he's sleeping in this chapter, the Lord speaks to him. And he thinks it's Eli. And he goes to him, asks him what he wants. He says, "I didn't call you." This happens 4 times. And finally, well, the priest tells him, "Look, lay down, and if the voice comes again, say, 'Here am I,' and humble yourself and say, 'Lord, speak.'" And so the Lord does speak to Samuel, not to Eli. And what he speaks is a judgment against Eli, that God is going to bring judgments against him and his family. And so because they won't hear, because they won't listen, because they won't obey, God goes around Eli and speaks to a young boy. There's a lot in the story, but I think one of the truths you can draw out of it is if you're not listening, if you're not obeying, if you're not taking what God has spoken to you and passing it on and let it shine through your life, God goes around you and he'll use someone else. Here he uses probably a 12-year-old who God raises up to be one of the best and strongest prophets in all of Israel. In fact, listen to what happens. "And Samuel grew, and the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all of Israel, from Dan to Beersheba," that would be like saying, you know, from New York to California, all across the nation, "he was established as a prophet, and the Lord appeared again at Shiloh, for the Lord revealed himself to Samuel at Shiloh by the word of the Lord." So the Lord reveals himself. And one of the primary ways he does in Samuel's life, in my life, in all of our lives, is by his word. The Lord speaks. And when he's not speaking, sometimes we need to ask ourselves, well, maybe he's not speaking like Eli because I haven't obeyed, because I haven't listened, because I've not been faithful. And sometimes God will use someone else to speak the word to you. He uses his Bible, he uses pastors, he uses friends, but God does want to speak, and he does want us to listen, and he wants us to obey, like Samuel. We had learned a great lesson through a young man by the name of Samuel.